There are three conditions which cause almost all instances of acute anorectal pain. First, an acute anal fissure. Second, a thrombosed external hemorrhoid. And third, an anorectal abscess. When assessing a patient with acute anorectal pain, here are a few questions which I ask to help pinpoint the diagnosis. First, when did the pain start and was there an initiating event? Pain that occurs after a hard BM suggests an acute anal fissure. Pain that started gradually over several hours suggests a thrombosed external hemorrhoid or an abscess. Is it a sharp, knife-like pain or a dull, constant pain? A sharp, knife-like pain with bowel movements suggests an anal fissure, while a dull, constant pain not associated with bowel movements suggests a thrombosed hemorrhoid or anorectal abscess. Is there a tender lump or swelling associated with the pain? A large lump suggests a thrombosed hemorrhoid. A tender swelling suggests an anorectal abscess. And finally, have they ever had this problem before, and do they have any underlying GI problems? If this is a recurrent problem, it may be an acute on chronic fissure, or a recurrent anorectal abscess associated with a fistula. If they have underlying GI complaints, this could be associated with inflammatory bowel disease and require further investigations. When I examine a patient with acute anal pain, I always reassure them that I am not here to hurt them and that if the pain is severe, I will stop the exam. Almost all acute problems around the anus can be diagnosed by inspection. A digital rectal exam in a patient with an acutely painful anus almost never provides useful information and just traumatizes both the patient and physician alike. When inspecting the perianal region, here are a few things I look for. A tender blue lump adjacent to the anus suggests a thrombosed external hemorrhoid. A tender red indurated swelling around the anus suggests an anorectal abscess. And a small edematous tag located in the anterior or posterior midline suggests an anal fissure. It is frequently difficult to see the actual fissure because people clench their buttocks as a result of the pain. You should try to gently spread the buttocks and avert the anus to see the fissure. If a diagnosis is not clear after you inspect a patient with acute anal pain, referral to a specialist should be undertaken.